Jessica Barden, 30, was born into a working-class family in North Yorkshire before rising to fame in shows such as The End of the Foxy World. The star has now claimed actors should not play characters from less privileged backgrounds, labeling it working-class tourism. It comes after Emma Karin said they would love to star in a gritty independent film after playing Princess Diana in The Crown and have an outrageous accent and red hair. Jessica is the daughter-in-law of Happy Days legend Henry Winkler, known for his character Fonzie, after tying the knot to his screenwriter son Max in 2021. She does not think posh actors and actresses should venture into the realm of playing working-class characters in shows and films. Speaking to the Sunday Times Culture magazine, she said, "I hate words like gritty or feisty. Gritty means working class and feisty means you have an opinion. I die inside when I read them. I was, like, why are you allowed to talk like this? How is working class tourism still okay for posh actors?" she added. Jessica, who now lives in Los Angeles with Max, has played roles including P. Gibbons in Jerusalem by Jez Butterworth at London's Royal Court Theatre. In her role, she was a drunk teen who came out from underneath the caravan worse for wear during the show. Her Yorkshire background is in stark contrast to Emma, who was born in Royal Tunbridge Wells. The star was privately educated at Woldingham School, went to Cambridge University and had a father who was a businessman and a speech therapist. Meanwhile, Jessica discussed what it's like to now live in sunny California, and admitted it is not too dissimilar to home. "Don't miss," she previously told NME, "the funniest thing is that Los Angeles doesn't feel that different to growing up in Leeds. A lot of people in LA have grown up here and never left, which feels like Leeds. And it's definitely a suburb. There's a 5-mile radius around West Hollywood, but the rest is where people live really quiet lives. It can be quite boring." When she first moved to London to pursue acting in 2009, alone, at the age of 16, she struggled. She lived all over town, including a stint in somebody's shed in Richmond, and had more than a few run-ins at local supermarkets. "I remember I couldn't change a light bulb, and I went to Sainsbury's and was like, 'Hi, is there anybody in here that can change my light bulb?' It's a wonder I didn't get killed." Jessica has done a lot of therapy to process that time, which was defined by loneliness.